Well, good morning. Welcome to Coffee with the Pastor. Hope you've got your coffee, and let's get into God's Word a little bit. We're in Mark chapter 8, and we'll begin with verse 14. The disciples had forgotten to bring bread, except for one loaf they had with them. And be careful, Jesus warned them. Watch out for the yeast of the Pharisees and that of Herod. They discussed this with one another and said, "It is because we have no bread." Aware of their discussion, Jesus asked them, "Why are you talking about having no bread? Do you still not see or understand? Are your hearts hardened? Do you have eyes but fail to see and ears but fail to hear? And don't you remember when I broke the loaves for 5,000, how many basketfuls of pieces did you pick up?" 12, they replied. "And when I broke the 7 loaves for the 4,000, how many basketfuls of pieces did you pick up?" Answered, 7. He said to them, "Do you still not understand?" So Jesus has fed the 5,000, and then he's turned around and fed 7,000. And then he's trying to give some serious advice to the disciples. He says, "Watch out for the yeast of the Pharisees." And they don't get it. And Jesus wasn't talking about bread. And the disciples, you know, they're not listening to what he has to say, because what he's saying is that the Pharisees were noted as being some of the most religious people in Israel that day. They were known for being very pious. And he was saying, you know, they're not all they're cracked up to be. You've got to be careful of people like that, who look one way but inside are differently. He's been trying to teach them that God looks on the inside, on the motives and the things. And so he's warning them about that. And he uses an illustration, which he always does, of leaven, which can affect all of the bread. And they're sitting there worried about bread. Disciples are pretty slow sometimes. And Jesus reminded me, said, "Why would I be worried about bread?" He said, "You saw me feed 5,000 with 5 loaves. You saw me feed 4,000 with 7 loaves. Why would I be afraid of that?" And so he basically tells them, what I like this, he says, "Your hearts are hardened. Do you not have eyes to see and ears to hear?" He says, "Aren't you paying attention?" And then to illustrate what he's done, it says that they came to Bethsaida, and some people brought a blind man and begged Jesus to touch him. And what he's going to do, he's going to take the blind man, and he's going to heal him. And he's going to put some spittle on his hands and put them on his eyes and rub it. And the guy's going to see kind of unclearly, and then he's going to see clearly. And I think that was deliberately put at that spot, because Jesus says, "Okay, you're watching me do all these physical things like providing bread, I'm feeding the multitudes, I'm healing the blind, yet you're not seeing the spiritual things that's happening as a result of this. There's a spiritual world going on. It's not just physical." One thing I did want to mention in this passage before we go, he says, "Watch out for the yeast of the Pharisees and that of Herod." Now, these are, at the time, very opposite people to put in the same sentence. First of all, the Pharisees and the Herodians and Herod didn't like each other. About the only time they ever came together was when they decided that Jesus needed to die. And they worked together to get that happening. But Herod, the Pharisees were religious zealots, and they believed in really keeping the law and doing all like that. But Herod was political. This may be as close to a political condemnation as we find in Jesus. I think he was telling his disciples, don't be like either one of them. Don't be so legalistic that you harm people in your religion. And then I think he's saying, and don't be like Herod, who plays politics and is willing to compromise his principles for, you know, to satisfy Rome and all like that. I think he's telling more of them to be against both those. Both those can corrupt you. And we've seen that in the church. Anytime you get a legalistic congregation, legalistic people, they tend to not be very loving. They tend not to be to care about the things it looks like that Jesus cared about. They don't care about grace and mercy and love. They care more about condemning and being judgmental. And in politics, we find that when the church gets in bed with politics and takes positions and like that, it tends to not go well. And so he was warning against both of those to his disciples. I think we would do well to be in that camp as well. Christians can be very quick to be very judgmental, to be very condemning when maybe we shouldn't be. We're quick to judge. And I think that's not the characteristics of Jesus. And so I hope we'll take the character of Jesus throughout our day. And tomorrow we're going to look at one of my favorite passages and in chapter 8. And I hope to see you tomorrow. Blessings on you, and go throughout your day being wary of being legalistic, judgmental, condemning like the Pharisees, maybe being too political, getting too caught up into politics. Neither one of them will get you where you want to go. Only Jesus. Blessings to you.